Good morning, boys and girls. Today is a very special day. Do you know why?
Today we are having a big celebration because today C4K is 9 weeks old.
Woo! But there is something even more important that we are also celebrating.
Oh really? What is that?
The Israelites are close to entering the Promised Land.
Wow, now that is a reason to celebrate.
Later on in this episode, we are going to hear more about the Israelites from Jake, who will be teaching for us.
Jake? Don't you mean Barry? I do get those two confused sometimes.
So do I. It's almost as if they were the same person.
Anyway, this week we have asked some of you to imagine what your perfect world would be like. This week, we're going to look at some of your creations that you have sent in.
Next, we're going to look at how well you all have remembered the memory verse along with the actions.
After that, we're going to look at some of your crazy rocket launches from last week's challenge.
Then, after the Bible story, we have a really fun song lined up which reminds us how good God is.
So, let's get the party started! Woo!
My dream world. It has a boat to bring friends, cute animals, houses or castles, fashion, movies, friendship, ice cream, horses that you can ride, cute little baby goats, lots of books, a beautiful play park, it's called Top Town, and the chickens will eat anything you want.
This is my paradise. The lollipops are trees and they grow sweet stuff for you. Now, there's also some little sticklers on the ground so you don't fall while it doesn't move or go about when it's a hurricane. There's also some in the garden. Now, the cars are not ordinary. The blue one is, but the purple is not normal. It's a PSA 4. And it has an attachment so you can attach to any other car as much as you like. That's the best part. And it can fly, and that's good. This is the place you really want to live in because it's always sunny, and sometimes, even if it's not raining, you can see a rainbow. You really want to live here.
My dream world. There is goats to stroke, friendship hall, and horses to ride, and a boat, an ice cream place.
Off you go.
This is what my perfect land would look like. Balloon making and a trip to the spa, candy floss machines, fairies on balconies and a picnic in the woods with lots of sunshine. The end.
This is a glimpse into what my perfect world would look like, with beauty and light and peace and calm all around us, a good cup of tea and yummy chocolate, great books to read, and God with us.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed, but every one was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed. Every one was fulfilled. Joshua 20:21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed, but every one was fulfilled. Joshua 21:45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed, but everyone was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed. Every one was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's promises to Israel failed, but every one was fulfilled.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed. Every one was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed. Everyone was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
Not one of all the Lord's good promises to Israel failed. Everyone was fulfilled. Joshua 21, verse 45.
And now it's time to have a look at your rocket launches.
Zita, take cover!
Ah! 2, 1, go!
This thing working? Come on, please function better.
Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Journey to the Promised Land. This week is our final episode in the series and it is called Remember the Lord. We're not remembering God like you would remember someone at a funeral, perhaps, or you would remember someone that you've not seen in a long time. That could be a friend that's gone away somewhere or a family member that's moved to another country. It's not that kind of remembering, but it's remembering what he has done for us and what that means for us now and in the future. But before we look at the story from the Bible, I want to share some experiences from my life where I've experienced the goodness of God.
When I was 13, I actually had to change schools. I went from a tiny wee school to a massive one. All of a sudden, everything had changed. I was so scared. I knew nobody. I wanted to go back to my old school. I got upset a lot. However, I knew deep down it was the right thing to do. So I prayed to God and trusted him. And you know what? He got me through it. I remember a few years later, I started at university. I've always loved football, and so the first thing I did was go and try out for the football team. Unfortunately, I went into it thinking I would play a bit like this.
Messi.
Oh. Ah! Messi!
This man is absolutely mad.
But I actually played like this.
Can I touch it?
Switch it.
Switch it.
What does that mean?
I don't know what you mean.
Switch it.
Sorry, guys. I was gonna.
I played in the trial match and was terrible. I did not get into any of the uni teams that day, and I was so disappointed, and I was very embarrassed. But again, God got me through it, and I was actually able to get into another team.
Well, those are just a couple of many times that God has helped me through a difficult situation of struggle or disappointment. However, God has helped me in one particular way that is more important than any other, and he's helped you in the same way. But before we get to that, let's have a look at our Bible story.
Today's story comes from Deuteronomy chapter 8 and the beginning of 9. Moses gives a big speech to all the Israelites. He explains how God has given them a second chance to enter the Promised Land. They will be able to enter and stay as long as they trust and obey God. To obey someone means to do what they tell us. So Moses reminds them of what God has told us to do. Those are his commandments. Moses warned the Israelites that it may be tempting to forget about this as they are distracted by all the amazing things in the Promised Land. The Bible says that it is the land of plenty, with wonderful food and wonderful things to drink. Even though they were extremely hungry and in a very bad condition in the wilderness, it was actually easier for them to remember God, as they had nothing else to rely on. It really was incredible what God did. He had rescued them from slavery in Egypt, and after 40 long years, they have reached the Promised Land. God wanted them to obey him, not just because it was their duty, but because they were thankful for everything that he had done. Our Christian life is similar. We can obey God not because he is like a mean teacher telling us what to do all the time, but we can do it as a thank you for what he has done for us. You see, God didn't just help me through the struggles and disappointments. He rescued me from the prospect of hell as he sent his only son Jesus to die in our place, to take the punishment that we are supposed to be getting. That's the most important thing. Not only am I now saved, but anyone else who believes and trusts Jesus, like I did, to forgive them, will also be saved. And God promises that all those who are saved will one day go to paradise, our very own promised land in heaven. Let me give you this illustration to make things clearer. Imagine there's this cowboy in the Wild West who sees a young lady in terrible danger. Then he goes and fights off the bad guys and gallops away on his horse, taking the young lady with him. As they arrive safely home, this might happen.
Oh, my hero, you saved me. How could I ever thank you?
Oh, shucks. Well, no thanks are necessary, ma'am. I'm just glad you're all right.
But, sir, surely there is some way I could express my gratitude. I thought those crooks were gonna turn me into beef jerky.
No, no, I insist. Take care of yourself, ma'am.
Oh, what a kind soul you are. Thanks again.
You see, after an incredible act of kindness and putting himself in danger, the cowboy has rescued this young lady, and she really wants to thank him. And you know what? It's the same with God. You see, God saved us from something so much bigger than just a few robbers in the Wild West. He saved us from punishment, from death. So, surely it is not too much for us to thank God for absolutely everything he's done. And thanking him doesn't just mean saying thank you in our prayers. We can live out our gratitude. We can live out our thanks for God by doing our best to remember him and by doing our best to obey his commands. Thank you for listening.
Sir.
Wow, don't you just love that song? Not only is it really catchy, it is also filled with truth. God is so good to us. But, like the Israelites, sometimes we can forget that God is good. And when we forget this, we can start disobeying God and think that we know better than Him. But, like the song reminds us, God gave us life and set us free. He set us free by sending His Son Jesus to die for us on the cross, so we could be friends with God again and live with Him forever. When we remember God's goodness, this helps us to obey God's good commands for our lives. Before we go on to our think, do, and pray, I have a challenge for all of you for next week. Earlier on, we saw some amazing perfect land creations. As a challenge, I would love all of you to create your own 3D perfect land. You can fill it with whatever you like, toys, games, Lego, and then send in a video of you describing your perfect land to us. When you're creating your perfect land, you can think about how what God is preparing for us, heaven, our promised perfect land, is so much better than the best perfect land that we could ever imagine. Now it's time for our think, do, and pray. Think. Think about the ways in which God has been so good to you. What could you thank God for? Do. Do create your perfect lands and send them into us, but also do find ways to share God's goodness with other people by doing something kind for them, remembering God's kindness to you. Pray. Pray to God and thank Him for all the good things He has given you, but most of all, for sending us Jesus. We're going to pray together now, so let's do our prayer drill. P R
A-Y, pray. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you so much for all the good things you have given to us. But thank you most of all for coming to die for us so that we could be friends with you again. Help us, God, to obey you as a thank you for how good you have been to us. Also, help us to show your goodness to our friends, family, and those around us. In your name we pray. Amen.